Everybody, welcome back to the channel, and of course we're making another Ninja 15 in one recipe. Today's is a nice spaghetti bolognese with a big twist. This has got in it chorizo and also red pesto, and it tastes so good. We're gonna put it under pressure like we normally do, layer it up. It's absolutely delicious, really easy and really quick. This is a winner in our household, and hopefully it'll be in yours as well. Let me show you what you're gonna need and how we're gonna make it. I think you all know by now that I don't make anything that's too difficult, too complicated, or anything that takes too long, because we have not got time in our evenings to be spending ages in the kitchen. So, sit and saute is on, and I'm adding in my chorizo, and this has been really finely diced. So in with that. Now I haven't added any oil into this at the moment. I might add a tiny bit of spray oil. It's not gonna need a lot. And now we just need to let all of that flavor come out of there. I just wanna cook that slightly before I add anything else in. Look at the color coming out of that already. It really doesn't take very long at all. This is gonna make such a great base of flavor for this. Oh, looks. Oh, it just smells incredible. Obviously, traditional methods are always good and always a classic to know. Sometimes I just like putting a little bit of a twist on things, add some extra flavors, make things a little bit more interesting if we can. And that is what this recipe is all about. Now I'm gonna add in my beef mince, and I'm just gonna break that up. The fat that's come out is really hot in the bottom here, so that's perfect to start frying this beef. As always, we're not trying to actually fully cook anything at this stage. We're just trying to create a nice flavor base, and then we can get it onto pressure cook once we've got all of this done. Into the meat, I'm also gonna add my diced carrot. So the chorizo was 100 grams, the beef mince was 500 grams, and then that was 2 chopped carrots. If you want to add onion, then I would add that now as well, or maybe slightly earlier. It depends how you like your onion, whether you want that sort of fried off or not. Now let's start seasoning this. So I'm gonna add in some black pepper. I'm not gonna add any salt because I'm gonna be using some stock, and that can be quite salty already, but that is up to you. I want 2 tablespoons of tomato puree. A tablespoon of dried mixed herbs. These ones that I've got are actually the Italian style ones, but the regular mixed herbs ones are fine as well. You can use fresh garlic in here, or you can use garlic granules like I'm doing. And I think really it's just personal taste, so I'm probably putting in a teaspoon-ish. Give that a little mix. I'm gonna turn off the sear and saute, we don't need that anymore. Next ingredient is some beautiful sun-dried tomato pesto. And we want a fair amount, so I would say a good 2 heaped tablespoons, which is probably more or less half the jar. Now to add in my passata, and that is 500 grams of passata. If you're not aware, then passata is just literally sieved tomato, so you've got no bits in it, it's just smooth. And then also 1 tin, which is 400 grams, yep, 400 grams of chopped tomatoes. Looking good. Now, as you know, to come to pressure, we need a lot of liquid. And when I talk about liquid, it has to be water-based, so you're looking at water or stock. I tend to use stock the majority of the time. So I'm just gonna go and make up some beef stock, and that'll be 350 milliliters. I'm using spaghetti and it doesn't fit very well. So what I always do is just grab a bundle, break it in half, and then I layer it that way, and then I layer the opposite way. And I'm just doing this to try and prevent it from sticking, because I have had that quite often where my spaghetti is all stuck together, and we want to try and make sure that this cooks as evenly as we possibly can. Okay, so I'm just dissolving my stock pot here. You can use whatever stock you want, but I just feel like because we're using the beef mince, beef makes the most sense really. So that is more or less done. I never worry if there's a few lumps because it's just going to cook out when we go under pressure. So what I do is I just now pour that over on top like this. Oh, look, it didn't dissolve very well at all, did it? My goodness. Never mind. And now I'm just going to push the spaghetti down so that it is getting covered. Doesn't matter if it's not fully submerged, but we have got some liquid there that's going to be able to cook this. That is everything in the pot. We are now ready to go under pressure. So need to get this little bit of spaghetti that's got stuck in the side there. Let's get that ready. Let's get the lid down and get it over to pressure cook. It shouldn't take too long to come up to pressure because we've used that boiling water. Make sure your vent up above is sealed. And I want to cook this on high, but we want a quick release because we don't want that pasta to overcook. And I have been doing this for 6 minutes and the pasta comes out perfect for me. So this has gone a little bit wrong this evening. My ninja was saying no pressure. So I'm showing you this basically so that if you get the same problem, you know what to do. I didn't really know what to do. So I pressed stop and now I am venting it. So I'm getting rid of the pressure that is in there for it to allow me to open it up. Now, it wasn't a lack of water. I know that for definite. So I think it must be something to do with my seal on my lid. So I might have to just adjust that and check that and try again. We got there in the end. I just had to check the seal and I redid it. So basically, it ended up being absolutely fine. So no problems at all, thankfully. And now I'm just going to put a little bit of Parmesan cheese over the top and just garnish it with some lovely fresh basil.